Hello Kiddos, how are you? Welcome back to my channel. On today's video, I want to talk with you about the books that I recommend you to get out of a reading slump. What is this? It's this moment of your life when you were going like from book to book to book to book, and then out of a sudden you feel not interested in finishing anything, you are not feeling motivated to start a new one, and you're actually needing this new story that it's going to put you back at it. So that's my intention for today's video, because this I think is something that happens to all of us. I will give you some recommendations that for me it worked really well to take me out of a reading slump every time that I had one. If you would like me to do a second part of this video, just please leave me on the comments, and please don't forget to subscribe and to like it, of course. Okay, so I believe all of us, we have different interests, so I will give you a lot of recommendations on each one of these genres, at least one recommendation for each one of these genres. Let's start. The first book that I want to recommend you is if you are looking for something more like a thriller, something that will keep you just at the edge of your seat, as if you were watching the latest episode of your favorite TV show. And that for me is The Northern Spy. This story, it's talk about Northern Ireland. It's about Tessa, who works for a TV station, basically. She's sort of a producer or something like that. And she has a sister that is called Marianne. Tessa helps to produce the most famous TV show, like a Good Morning America, like these type of shows. And I think it's like one day she finds out that the woman that they're going to talk in the news, it's her sister Marianne, who was disappear, and she apparently has joined the IRA, something that I have no idea about. And actually I have a friend that is from Northern Ireland, and while I was reading this book I was talking with her so much about this, because I find these stories that has a political or historical context as a background, they're way more interesting because it's a new way to learn about like some specific moment in history. I think it's written in a way that you will find it like super captivating. You're gonna go through the pages super quickly because you want to know what was the truth. You want to know why she was disappeared, and it has a little twist. This is a fiction book, so if you're interested in historical fiction, or if you're interested in like the things that are happening maybe like in some real events that you have heard about but don't know much about it, I think this book is going to do really good for you. I found myself going through the pages super quickly, but it's one of those that you are slowing it down just because you don't want to finish, and it was that good. Yeah, if you haven't, make yourself a favor and read The Northern Spy. The other book that I want to recommend you, it's something that it's also short. I think that if you're in a reading slump and then I give you a little life, that it's a book that has 800 pages, you're not going to feel very motivated to read it. So I think that short books kind of like do it better in that sense. And if you're looking for something that it's like self-help, but at the same time, you don't want to read a self-help book, I think that the best thing that you can do is to read The Midnight Library. It talks about this woman called Norma, that in a moment when she's going through a hard moment in her life, she decides to give up. The thing is like, she goes to another dimension where all the decisions that she could have made on her life, they're all represented by books. It's a very short story. It's a very easy reading story. It feels a lot like a self-help book. You're going to end it up with a heartwarming feeling and like a very nice message. The book doesn't go in depth on all the aspects of mental health. So I think in that case, if you're going through something like that and you pick up this book, you're not going to feel very represented. But if you're in a reading slump and you're looking for something that is going to make you feel good, I will recommend this one. If instead you're looking for something like more romantic, I will definitely recommend you a book by Colleen Hoover. I started with Ugly Love. That was the first book that I read from her. In her novels, there's always something that is happening. There's always something that you're waiting for. And all the chapters always ended up with something that will keep you interested for the next one. The latest one that I have read from her, it's It End With Us. That it's a book that has been talked about everywhere by everyone. So I wanted to read something that was a love story, and one of my friends was reading this one. She also said that it feels like very represented on something that has happened in previous relationships. So I started it. I thought it was going to be maybe a really cute story, but instead it was a story that I still, till today, I have in my mind. This one basically talks the story about Lily. She has a flower shop, and then she falls in love with this guy that is called Ryle. Seems like he's going to make her super happy, and it's one of those moments when you really click with someone and fall in love deeply. But then, out of the sudden, the things with that person starts to change when violence enters the room. I think that I enjoyed the story, totally enjoyed the way that the characters were developed, but it was actually the note from the author at the end of the book, and she talks about what story from her personal life has inspired this story. It's very heartbreaking, and I've known a lot of these type of stories. Sometimes you wonder, like, why these couples stay together if they're like destroying each other in every way possible. And her voice on the book, I think that gives it like a completely different perspective. If you're in a reading slump, you're going to enjoy a lot. You're not going to be able to put it down, I promise. And the other one that I want to talk about is just a book that I finished 3 days ago or something, and I read it super quickly. That one is Malibu Rising by Taylor Jenkins Reid. The way that she writes, so captivating, and like, so it will make you feel so immersed into the story that you will start feeling that the characters are real. And that happened in this book, and it happens also in The Seven Husbands of Evelyn Hugo, and it happens as well in Daisy Jones and the Six. In all these books, I think, especially in Daisy Jones and the Six, you want to know more about the band, you want to listen to the songs that they talk about, and that makes it like a completely different experience. This one is the only book from Taylor Jenkins Reid that I have the physical copy, that's why I chose it, because I just finished it. It's a very captivating story. It talks about the family Riva, and they actually live in Malibu. They have like this big house. The father is a rock star, and just one day the house is on fire. It happened after a party that they used to do every year. It was a very interesting story. I don't think that it's my favorite book from Taylor Jenkins Reid. If in your country it's summer and you want to go to the beach and you say like, oh, I want to look cool, go to the beach, maybe read something, but also feel like I'm going to be connected with the characters and be enjoying it, well, definitely pick up this one. So these are my recommendations if you're going through a reading slump. As I say, this is going to be part one. If you want me to do part two, just leave it in the comments. And also, if you have read any of these books, just please leave it in the comment, because I would love to know what you feel and have heard about it. I will see you next week in another video. Thank you so much for watching. Bye bye.
Let's go. Yeah. I'm like an addict, do I gotta have it? I ain't even playing, got a really bad habit. If it moves, gotta grab it. Fuse like a magnet, lose, won't have it till I'm doomed in a casket.